safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside. Great. More clocks.
Making four clocks?
This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside. Great. More clocks. Is that? It's making more clocks. This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside. Great. More clocks. What is that? It's making more clocks? This is the safe room Welsh showed me. The one with the altered. Great. More clocks. This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside. Thank you. Great. More clocks. What is that? It's making more clocks? This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside. Great. More clocks. What is that? It's making more clocks? Oh! This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside.
Great. More clocks.
What is that? It's making more cops? This is the safe room Will showed me. The one with the altered item inside.
Great. More clocks.
What the fuck is that?
More clocks? There. No wonder the Rangers had such a hard time with that one.
Did she have to write everything in her made-up gibberish code? Fucking Marshall with her CIA spy shit. God.
I found this token. Any idea what it does?
That is a jukebox token. Little bastards turn up in the weirdest places, like bad pennies. The Rangers use them to activate an old object of power.
A jukebox, I assume. Does it have any good songs?
Nope, just the one record. Hey, be careful turning it on, though. When it's playing, you get a free trip to the formation.
The formation? That sounds ominous. Why does it send you there?
Now, the Bureau has been wondering that for years. I mean, it's just a pile of rocks built by God knows who, but... Well, researchers have confirmed it's in the same threshold as the quarry. Well, no one's ever been able to map a physical route to the formation for maintenance.
So it's in the quarry? You just don't know where?
Pretty much. We only send in annual expeditions to the formation now. Checkups, Salvador calls them. This year's team went in the day the Hiss arrived. Come to think of it, the song should have brought him back hours ago.
I can go in and take a look.
I'd appreciate that. The jukebox is kept just past the security booth over there. Just put in the token and enjoy the ride.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know. See you soon.
Is purely antithetical to every variant of the Hiss signal I can arrange. But how did Darling create?
No, it's happening. After all these years, Dylan is here. But am I too late? How is he? I need to know.
He's clearly been affected by the Hiss, but it's different than any other manifestation we've recorded. Maybe what makes you so special is genetic. He was a prime candidate. Or maybe it's Polaris protecting him, something else affecting the situation. I need to run tests. He seems more in control, more present.
I want to see him. My brother. Or is he?
Of course. Now, Marshall set up an HRA warded cage to contain him. It's on the upper floor, up the stairs.
Okay, I need to go.
Jesse. Be careful.
Did you hear that the Hiss prisoner they captured is the director's brother?
Brother? And she brought him here? She's gonna get us all killed.
What if she's working with the Hiss? Isn't it strange she showed up just when he did?
How's it looking out there? I don't think I ever told you this, but I was actually on the path to being a Ranger once. Did the whole boot camp thing. Even got rookie status. Anyway, not the point. My own Ranger squad was a great bunch. There was six plus me. Remus, Hazard, Cho, Guy, Hepton, Stoll, and Thompson. They were supposed to get back from an expedition yesterday. We had beers and wings planned. Problem is, they weren't here when Darling handed out the HRAs.
Then they had nothing protecting them from the Hiss.
You see, they prepped for the worst, but I think that we're already past that. We all wore these pouches around our neck, and I really don't want the Hiss to get them. Could you find them for me? The squad would have come back through maintenance, but they probably spread out from there.
I'll keep an eye out for them, Arish. And I won't let them stay Hiss. I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
We're gonna get through this.
Stored HRA production. They're already getting other survivors out of safe rooms.
Great. Maybe I can get back to my office soon. I'm just having a door to close on.
I think you're gonna have to endure the meeting.
What do you know about this Arish guy?
I heard some rangers saying you saved them in maintenance.
They were attacked by a new kind of hiss, and Arish got them.
All right, but still, a security guard leading rangers? Marshall orders us to just sit on our asses and then leaves? What's the deal?
She must have her reasons.
That's Dylan.
Can you hear me?
Oh, come on, Dylan. I'm here. I found you. Do you know who I am? Oh, you know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
He's talking in the third person. Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan. Trench and Darling made sure of that. I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been the new you. You want this
Please
to be
that.
True.
Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them. They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head. If he is still in there, if there is anything left, you have to help me.
You! You came in through the hole in you We let you in. You've always been here. The only truth. A copy of a copy of a copy of a copy.
Stop it!
Orange Peel!
Shit! Shit! He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister when we were very small. In ordinary. In the desert, through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away. She didn't give me any powers. All the powers are my own powers. She didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The air cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found... They opened the door up to the Hiss. That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the Altered World event in Ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
An earworm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream, baby. Baby, baby, yeah. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
I welcomed the Hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The Hiss set me free. Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the Hiss.
Your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister, the horrible truth about the Bureau. The Hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate program in the containment sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to have it.
Wanted? Bullshit. I saw what the Hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this slide projector. You can help me. We can end this.
You are a worm through time. That you are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness come.
I don't know what else I'm hoping to find here.
Dylan. Can we talk?
I'd like to tell you about a dream I had last night.
Off to a good start.
Okay. I'm listening.
I was back in Ordinary, before all of this happened. But in the dream, I was alone. It was just me. I was the only child. A girl. My name was Jesse Dylan Faden. But then the Bureau came and caught me, brought me back here. Lock me up. Have you ever noticed that our names, Jesse, Dylan, they could be girls' names, boys' names, could be anything. Don't you find that weird? I find that weird.
Sure.
What the hell was that? Is he trying to mess with me?
You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes with white pearls, but yellow and red in the eye. You are a mirror of evil.
Maybe Dylan's still in there. Maybe there's a way to reach him.
I'd like to talk to my brother, please. Dylan?
Dylan would like to tell you about a dream he had just now.
This again?
I was going to be the new director of this place. I helped you get a job here, so that we could be together. You were an office assistant. You'd make coffee and deliver the mail, and there was always plenty of work to do. And it stayed that way, forever and ever. It was nice. Really nice.
That's debatable.
But here's the strange thing. The dream shifted, and none of it was real anymore. It was a game. We were in a game, and it was a fucking boring game. But you couldn't stop playing. And then it shifted again. Or maybe it was another dream already. Or maybe I'm just confusing them. But in this other dream, it was more like a musical. This is an ordinary song about an ordinary girl from an ordinary town. It's the ordinary story. She worked an ordinary job in an ordinary office and something, 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 something. And that's all I can remember of that dream.
Maybe that's for the best.
You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you.
Maybe I can learn more about the hiss from him.
Can we talk?
I just had an interesting dream.
Shit.
That's fascinating, but let's talk about the hiss for a change, yeah?
This dream was about the hiss.
Best I'm gonna get.
In my dream, the hiss had broken free of this prison, this house. I'd set it free. And the president himself was there to welcome us. He was the first one to take the hiss in. Spread the word. At first, many people thought it was horrifying. That he was horrifying. But also, many people who heard his words wanted to welcome the hiss in. And slowly, more and more of them came around, until the whole world was brought together by the hiss. It was wonderful.
Okay, thanks for sharing that.
For the record, that will never happen. Not as long as I'm alive.
The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes.
Maybe I'm just here to punish myself.
Any new dreams you'd like to share, Dylan?
I'm glad you asked, sister. This dream, like all dreams now, felt very real. Like reality. And reality now feels like a dream. Maybe it's all a dream. Maybe it's all real.
Dream where my brother endlessly tells me about his dreams.
I was in a dark place, and there was a dark man there. His name was Mr. Door, and he told me that there are many worlds, side by side, on top of each other, some inside of others. In one world, there was a writer who wrote a story about a cop. In another world, the cop was real. Dor said he himself was in all of them at the same time, endlessly shifting between them. I asked him how I could reach these worlds. I wanted to bring the hiss there. But he didn't want to help me. He didn't like the idea. What did he know?
I'm not wild about the idea myself.
Through time, the Thunderstorm distorts your happiness.
Here we go again. Once more with feeling.
Let me guess. You want to tell me about your dream?
Yes. Yes. In fact, I'm having a dream right now.
Oh. That's new.
In this dream, I'm standing in the corner watching Jesse and Dylan talk about this very dream. This very dream! He said just now! And repeated it again now! I'm standing there and watching, and that's all I can do. It's as if I'm trapped there. And that's all I have to say about that dream.
Okay, okay, Dylan. That's good.
Is he still in there? Or is this the Hiss playing mind games? I don't know.
Leave your inside by the door. Push the fingers through the surface into the way. You've always been here. You are in control. We stand around you while you dream. You can almost hear our words, but you forget. This happens now.
Why haven't you dissected that freak mutation we locked up? So much from his physiology. He's a valuable resource.
Careful in there, ma'am. Area's under quarantine.
I wouldn't go in there without talking to Underhill first.
Even if you have, I still wouldn't go in. Area's under quarantine.
I wouldn't go in there without talking to Underhill first.
Even if you have, I still wouldn't go in.
Thank you. Building shifts occur at random and without warning, but with the Bureau's cutting-edge technology, we can stabilize the oldest house, safe employees, happy employees. Certain rituals allow agents to navigate the oldest house as well. But accidents do happen. Trapping agents inside the walls. I heard you got stuck in your room for 3 days, Topher. Too bad you didn't have your book with you. Or any food. And remember, kids, when you feel the floor deviate, it's already much too late.
Thank you. P6 and P7.
I can see you're upset, Meg. Why don't you tell Uncle Mr. Bones what's wrong?
I did bad on my clairvoyance test.
You can't ace every test, Meg. You see, everyone has different brains. Some brains can talk to each other. We call this ESP.
ESP?
Some brains can lift objects like a baseball. Talk about a fly ball, eh, Meg?
No interruptions!
So who cares if you fail your clairvoyance test? Maybe your brain can throw baseballs or talk to dead people. or make friends blind. Once we know what your brains can do, we'll know what job to give you. And if your brains are just right, you'll get to sit in the big chair.
What if I don't want the big chair?
What if I don't want the big chair?
Everyone wants the big chair, Hank!
That's why we're all here. Use those brains to listen for once, or the only chair you'll get in is the one with straps.
I wish things had gone differently in Ordinary for us. But wishing won't change things.
Ordinary.
Finding the projector will.
So much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden. Prime Candidate 6. And the sister as well, once we catch up with her. But the boy. So much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable. There was an incident. Yes. A valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter. We need to find that projector. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me.
We used to play there all the time. Me and Dylan, and other kids as well. We loved it. This time, I remember, was different. We found a way in, deeper into it, like it had shifted.
That's where we found this life.
They studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking. Dylan and I were both prime candidates. Experiments. We're going back home. Of course we are. It started there, and it's never gone away. There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. Thank you.
gotta be able to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel here. Something's blocking it.